What's up, guys? Justin here with thecgessentials.com, back with another Blender modeling tutorial for you. So this is a series I've kind of wanted to do for a while, where I talk through some different kind of simple shapes, or we can talk about different principles that we can use to model inside of Blender. So in today's video, we're going to talk about how to model a bowling pin inside of Blender. So let's go ahead and just jump into it. All right, so remember that it's usually a good principle to use a reference image when you're trying to model things like this, because when you try to eyeball it, it's not going to be ideal. So I'm just using a simple vector graphic right here, which I will link to in the notes down below. It's from Pixabay, so there's information here about the person that uploaded that, but you can download this and we can work with that. And so what we're going to do is we're going to start by importing that image. And so one thing to remember when you're doing this is your camera view when you bring your image in is going to be really important. So we're going to bring in an image by doing a Shift A, and under image we're going to click on reference. So when we click on reference, we're going to go find our image. And we can just double click on it to bring it in. But notice how the problem with this image is it gets brought in at an off axis, right? So even if I scale it down and I start trying to draw on it, things are gonna get really tricky because it's like, it's a little off, which is not what you want. Now you could come in here and you could like, under the item, you could adjust the rotation so that it's proper the way that we want it to be, but it's a lot easier to make sure that you're in a front up and down viewport. And so you can get into that view just by clicking on the red dot in your viewport right here. You could also do a control and then a numpad 3. But what that does is that puts us in the straight up and down view, and it's going to import this image aligned with our camera. So we're going to do a Shift A, image. We're going to find a reference image. We're going to go find our bowling pin image and bring it in. Notice how this is set to align to view. So this is aligned with our straight up and down view. But if I double click on this, notice how that's going to bring our image in. Well, then we can scale it down just like this to more of a proper size. And so I'm assuming this is going to be about right. I'm just going to move it up using the move tool. So I'm just going to type G and then Z to lock it on the blue axis and move it up. I'll go ahead and delete out my default model. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna model out our pin. And so one of the best ways to go about something like this is to start by finding a shape that's kind of close to the shape you wanna create, right? Well, in this situation, probably the closest shape that we have is a cylinder. So we're gonna do a Shift A, we're gonna add a mesh, and we're gonna go find a cylinder. And so when we bring the cylinder, we're going to build off of this shape in order to create our bowling pin. So I'm just going to scale this down, and notice how right now I've got a little bit of a problem here in the sense that I can't see my image, right? So I'm going to type G and I'm going to move this up, but notice how I can't actually see my image in here. Well, what we want to do is we just want to tap the Z key and go to wireframe mode. Well, when we go to wireframe mode, what that does is that allows us to see through the faces in our object. And so that's gonna allow us also to select things that are kind of hidden behind when we go into edit mode. So we're gonna go back into front, straight up and down view, but just make sure by tapping Z and going to wireframe that you're in wireframe mode. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna go into edit mode. So I'm just going to select my cylinder, hit the tab key, and that's gonna take me into edit mode. And we're gonna start editing this so that it works with our pin. And so the way that I'm gonna do that is, first of all, I'm gonna type G to move this down. I'm gonna type Z to lock it to the blue axis. I'm just gonna align this pretty closely with the bottom right here. So you can see how the bottom of my cylinder is aligned right here. This isn't really that big of a deal because we can move the different edges around. But what I want to do is I want to start adding detail. And so I can do that by, well, first what I'm going to do is I'm going to select the top of this, and then I'm going to type G, and I'm just going to move it up. I'm going to type the Z key to lock it to the blue axis, and I'm just going to move it all the way to the top of my pin. And we're just going to kind of adjust this as we go. So one other thing is I might want to move this to the left just a little bit. It's not the end of the world, but it's a little off. So I'm just going to type A to select all, G, and then I'm going to type the Y key in order to lock this to the Y axis. And I'm just going to move it over just a little bit so that it's centered on my pin. Well, now we're going to start adding detail. So to add detail, what we're going to do is we're going to start by selecting these edges right here and tapping the S key. So when we tap the S key, what that's gonna do is that's gonna scale this object about the center. So what I'm gonna do, so I'm just gonna scale this in so that it basically matches the width of my pen. And you can also move this around just by tapping the G key and then just moving these different objects. And so now we need to add some detail. So what we can do is we can just do a Control R to add a loop cut. So notice how when we add a loop cut, we can single click with our left mouse button and we can move this up or down. Well, I'm gonna move this loop cut down and then I'm gonna left click. What that's done is that's added a loop in here so that we can add detail to our pin. And so I'm just gonna go back to this straight up and down view. Note that it's really important that you're doing this from the straight up and down view. Note that it's gonna be best to do this from the straight up and down view just to make sure that you're getting everything aligned. But I'm just gonna take that edge loop right here. I'm just gonna tap the S key to scale it up. So notice how when I scale it up, I'm aligning it with the outside edge of this object. And so I'm just gonna keep adding detail to this object. So I'm just gonna do a Control R and a single click. We're gonna move this loop cut down here. And I'm just gonna scale that out. Now notice how you don't have to get perfect with this because we're going to use the subdivision surface modifier a little later to add more detail. For now, what I wanna do is I wanna make sure that I'm capturing all of the main geometric points in here. So for example, you can see how I wanna make sure that I capture the widest part. I wanna make sure I capture where this starts moving in just by doing this same thing. So I'm just gonna go through and I'm just going to add all of this detail. And one thing I want to make sure that I do is I want to make sure that I have a loop where this red piece is going to be, because we're going to take the geometry inside of that loop and we're going to apply a different material to it. So I'm going to do a Control R, I'm going to left click, and I'm going to move this down so that it aligns with the top of this red stripe, just like this. I'm going to add another, put it at the bottom of this stripe. I'm going to add another and put it at the top of this stripe. And I'm just gonna scale that in using the S key as well. And so what that's gonna do, and I'm gonna go back into material preview mode for a second, is that's gonna give us a loop of geometry that we can select in order to apply our material to. So that's why I want this to be separate geometry in here for the little red pieces. But I'm just gonna go back to wireframe mode, finish adding all of this detail. And I'm gonna go ahead and take the top, scale that in, just like this. All right, so you can see how that's given us our general bowling pin shape. And if we wanted to look at it a little bit closer, we could tab into object mode and then tap the H key in order to hide our image. So you can see how we've got our general shape, but now what we want to do is we want to add some geometric detail. And so the way that we're going to add this detail is by selecting our pin. Make sure that you're in object mode when you do this. And then we're just going to click on this and we're going to go into our modifiers. And in this case, we want to add a subdivision surface modifier. So we're going to click on subdivision surface. Notice how what that did is that started smoothing out our object. And you can adjust this a little bit to see what it would look like rendered. So you can move this up or down in order to see what the pin is going to look like. And so everything looks pretty good. I'm not going to worry too much about the top right here, but if we take a look at the bottom, from a straight up and down view, you can see how that's gonna be a little bit problematic. And so let's go ahead and turn our image back on by clicking on the eye right here. Well, notice how what this is doing is this is taking the bottom part of our object and it's subdividing it in, and you're getting this like really ugly point right here. And the reason for that is because the bottom piece here isn't made of quad geometry. So it's just kind of like pulling it in and making this star, but we also haven't given it anything to do with that. So what we want to do is we want to fix that just a little bit. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select my cylinder. I'm going to tab into object mode. We just want to add some more detail here. So the first thing I want to do is I want to add a loop cut right here at the bottom. That'll keep this from pinching everything in. So I'm just gonna do a Control R, click, and then notice how as I move my mouse down, this is becoming much less pronounced in the way that it's subdividing this in. So I wanna move this down, and I'm just gonna take this whole thing, I'm gonna select it and make sure that you're in wireframe mode when you do this so that you get all of your pieces. And I'm gonna tap the G key and the Z key, I'm just gonna drag this down a little bit more. So now, if we were to tab out of here, go back into material preview mode, you can see how this looks a lot better. And one other thing we might wanna do, I'm gonna do this from not straight up and down view in this case, is I'm gonna select this, I'm gonna tab into edit mode again, and I just wanna select this face, so I'm gonna tap 3 to go into face select mode. I'm gonna click on the face, and I'm gonna inset this in by tapping the I key. And so when I inset this in, basically what we're doing is we're adding another piece of geometry right here. Well, when we add this other piece of geometry, what that's gonna do is that's really gonna smooth out our bottom piece. And then we can just move that up by tapping G and then Z. Just like this. And then we're gonna inset it in a fair amount more just to kind of avoid that little star shape as much as we can. So I'm gonna inset that in. And in this case, I may need to inset it again, like this. I'm just gonna move it up just a bit more. So now, if I tab back into object mode and we take a look at this, we'll go ahead and hide our image. If we tab back into our object mode, you can see we have a much better bowling pin shape. And so this is about as detailed as I want to get for the geometry in here, but let's go ahead and add some materials. So we don't want this to just be this white color, right? We want it to have a white kind of glossy color applied to it. We also want red to be where those little ribbons would be. So to do that, we just go into material properties, and let's go ahead with our cylinder selected and click on new. And so in this case, we're gonna be very simple with this. And so we're just gonna leave this as the white color. But what we wanna do is we also wanna tab back into object mode. And we're gonna turn our image back on real quick. What we wanna do is we want to go back into wireframe mode. We're gonna go to our straight up and down view, and we wanna select the faces that we want to be red. So I'm just gonna do a shift, and I'm gonna drag a box so that we can select all of these faces. Well, right now, these all have this white material applied to them. Well, what I wanna do is I wanna add a second material slot to this object. So I'm just gonna click on plus right here. We're just gonna add a new material. We're gonna change our base color to red. And with these faces selected, we wanna click on assign. And so when we click on assign, now if I go back to material preview mode, and we're gonna hide our image, you can see how what we've done is we've assigned a white material to most of our pin, and then along these faces right here, we have a red material associated with them. And so one other thing I wanna show you, and you don't have to do things this way, but it could probably save you some time in the future, is usually you're not gonna have an individual bowling pin, right? What you're gonna do is you're gonna have 10 of them. And so what we wanna do is we wanna place some of those pins. And probably what you've seen before is you've seen people doing a shift D to duplicate, right? They do a shift D, and then we just tap the Y key in order to move this over. And we've duplicated this. But the problem is, let's say we were to make a change, right? Let's say we were to go back and we were to change the color on this one to something else. So, and we'll go to straight up and down view. Let's say that we were to take these faces and apply a green color, like this. So, something like this. We'll put like a darker green color on here. And we'll go ahead and assign that. Well, notice how we've changed this one pin, but the other pin didn't change with it. That's fine if you want them to all be individual objects, but what I want is I want these to be linked so that if I change one, all of them are gonna change. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna undo out of this, and instead of doing a shift D, what I wanna do instead is I wanna do an alt D. So if I do an alt D, what that's gonna do is that's gonna create a linked duplicate. So I'm just gonna move this over like this. Well now, let's say that we were to adjust this material, right? So we'll go to straight up and down, and we'll add that green material again. So something like this, we'll click on assign. Well, notice how now, when I made that change, this object right here changed along with it. Well, the reason for that is because this object is linked to this object. So now, anytime I make a change to one, you're gonna get a change on the other as well. And so the last thing we're gonna do, and I didn't do a very good job of picking up all of those because I wasn't in wireframe mode, that is okay. So the last thing we're gonna do is we're just gonna go to a top-down view, and we're just really quickly gonna create our copy. So I'm just gonna click and drag across this. I'm gonna do an Alt-D, tap the Y key right here, and then click. Then I'm going to select these three. I'm going to do an Alt-D and remove these over here. Then I'll select these two, do an Alt-D, move these over here. Then I'll select this, do an Alt-D, and move this over here. What I've been able to do is I've been able to create all of these different bowling pins that are all linked together so that if I change one, the others change as well. So that's where I'm going to end this video. Leave a comment below and let me know what you thought. Would you like to see more step-by-step tutorials like this on modeling? I just love having that conversation with you guys. If you like this video, please remember to click that like button down below. If you're new around here, remember to click that subscribe button for new Blender content every week. As always, thank you so much for taking the time to watch this. I really appreciate it, and I will catch you in the next video. Thanks, guys.